On June 7th of 2023, the Mayon Volcano began a new eruption as lava finally pushed upwards onto a lava dome emplaced in 2018. Small sections of this dome were then pushed to too steep of an angle, causing rock fragments to collapse and rockfall events, with larger events even releasing pyroclastic flows. It is now day 10 of Mayon's eruption, and volcanic activity is visible over a wide radius due to an abundance of lava avalanches produced on its slope, where fragments of viscous molten rock break off from the main lava dome and tumble down Mayon's near 45 degrees slopes. I have attempted to geolocate the lava flow shown in this video clip, which appears to be occurring on Mayon's southern slope, with fragments of material in the lava flow traveling up to 1140 meters from Mayon's summit in that direction. Although lava in of itself can be a deadly hazard, this is not currently the most significant hazard at the volcano, as that would instead be pyroclastic flows. These superheated gas currents, which regularly produce temperatures beyond 500 degrees Celsius, can incinerate everything in their path and have so far traveled up to a distance of 2600 meters away in the current eruption. However, there is always the possibility that a larger pyroclastic flow could occur, hence the current 6-kilometer exclusion zone in all directions around Mayon's summit. This exclusion zone has resulted in the evacuation of 17,000 people. And I know those of you who have evacuated do not want to hear this, but you may be unable to return to your home for perhaps as long as several months. Although we do not know how long the current eruption of Mayon will last for, if you look at Mayon's eruptions since 2000 and exclude brief phreatic eruptions which lasted under 36 hours, the remainder of the eruptions lasted for at least 45 days or more. Thus, statistics suggest that Mayon will probably still be erupting until at least July 21st, 2023. In an attempt to determine how explosive Mayon's eruption will be, we will look at its geophysical data. Although the number of daily rockfalls at Mayon has largely continued to increase, in the last 3 days it has remained fairly constant, suggesting a fairly consistent supply of magma feeding the eruption, which is not greatly increasing or decreasing. The lava which is effusing probably has either a basaltic andesite or andesite composition, and this is feeding the creation of gas plumes which are remaining under 800 meters in height above Mayon's summit. The number of volcanic earthquakes has also remained fairly low since the eruption began, suggesting that there is not a significant buildup in pressure under Mayon's summit lava dome. This is a good thing as it makes powerful explosions that might trigger an expanded evacuation zone unlikely for now. However, the most important figure to look at is the amount of sulfur dioxide gas Mayon is producing. Generally speaking, the amount of shallow magma present strongly correlates with the amount of sulfur dioxide which is emitted. While a baseline, or what is considered normal when Mayon is not erupting, is under 500 tons of sulfur dioxide a day, Mayon during the last 7 readings has averaged 620 tons a day. To understand what exactly this suggests, since Mayon has produced a wide range of eruption intensities during the last 200 years, ranging from fairly peaceful, primarily effusive eruptions with negligible, if any, explosive components to them, to highly explosive planian eruptions, I present this chart. As you can see, since the current daily levels of sulfur dioxide emissions are not currently in the thousands of tons, a highly explosive eruption for now is not expected. Instead, the current eruption is most consistent with a VEI-0 eruption, although it might be slightly more gas-rich than the 2014 eruption, as that eruption averaged under 500 tons sulfur dioxide emissions a day. Yet, although Mayon's eruption is seemingly most consistent with a VEI-0 eruption, it could theoretically be in a very weak VEI-1 territory as the volcano has produced 33 pyroclastic flows between June 7th and June 16th. In my opinion, I would not be too concerned about the evacuation radius of Mayon expanding due to an intensifying eruption unless a sudden spike in volcanic earthquakes occur, or there are 2 or more days in a row with more than 1,000 tons of sulfur dioxide gas being produced. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.